Hey everyone, Hungry Cat here. Thanks for joining me for a behind the scenes look at episode 3 of my Bartram Trail thru-hike. This episode covers days 5 and 6 of the hike all the way through to the end. On day 5, I woke at Wilson Gap, roughly mile 84.1, to a lovely clear morning. The hiking heading out of the gap was beautiful and I got some great shots with the sunbeams coming down through the forest. One of the classic features of the Bartram Trail are the handful of trail signs that are carved directly into rocks along the way. There was a sign at Windy Gap that was slowly being reclaimed by the mountain. Part of it was already beneath the dirt. I don't know how long it originally was, but I wondered how long it would take before the mountain reclaimed the whole thing. The day got pretty hot and it was finally not raining, but there was a lot of water for me to drink on this section. I passed by Courthouse Gap where there's a side trail up to a place called Pinnacle Knob that has amazing views. I didn't take the side trail as I can do this and have done it previously as a day trip from War Woman Dell, but it's definitely worth the hike up to see the views if you haven't been up there before. The area from Courthouse Gap down to War Woman Dell has lots of beautiful cascades, waterfalls, and plenty of camping options. Climbing out of War Woman Dell was tougher than I expected. The climb to get up to the ridge was steep, it was hot, and there really wasn't any water until I got back down by the Chattooga River later on. There were a lot of blueberry bushes on this section of trail though, so I enjoyed eating the occasional blueberry as I hiked along. On my last night of camping, I had good weather, so I made a little fire in my fire ring by the Chattooga River. I've kayaked the Chattooga River many times, and it's one of my favorite paddling spots. It's famous for its whitewater, particularly this section of larger rapids known as Five Falls, which was featured in the 1970s film Deliverance, if you remember that scene where they're trying to go through the rapids in the canoe. Any hike along the Bartram Trail could be complemented with a whitewater rafting trip on the Nantahala River near the northern terminus or on the Chattooga River down south. I finally made it back to Russell Bridge and the southern terminus marker the next day. Unfortunately, there was a bit of graffiti on the marker, which is a shame, but it kind of underscores the weird feeling I get when I'm back in quote-unquote civilization. When people refer to civilization, they generally mean the most advanced forms of cultural and social organization and development. So maybe I wasn't really back to civilization, because I think we can do better than a bit of graffiti on a rock. Nevertheless, I still had that feeling of accomplishment when I finished the trail, and the graffiti couldn't take away from that. The Bartram Trail was full of tough challenges that I enjoyed, and I learned a lot about the trail and myself along the way. This wraps up my series on the hike itself, but I do have a video coming out next week on logistics and navigation for hiking the Bartram Trail. So if you're interested in learning more about hiking the Bartram Trail, stay tuned for that. If you like this video or found any value in it, please do hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share it with a friend or on your social media. Thanks so much as always for watching, and I will see you soon in the next video.